स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर विद अ वेरी न्यू पोयम, रग्बी चैपल, कंपोज्ड बाय मैथ्यू आर्नोल्ड एंड ही वाज अ विक्टोरियन पोएट. रग्बी चैपल इज आल्सो एन एलिजी लाइक थॉमस ग्रेज एलिजी रिटन इन अ कंट्री चर्च यार्ड, बट इट इज वेरी डिफरेंट. Very different from that of Elegy, because Gray's Elegy was an impersonal elegy and Rugby Chapel is a personal elegy. It is very emotional, very heart touching. We can say, because it is a personal elegy, we can say that it is autobiographical. It is just like a tribute paid to the father, tribute of a son to his father, to his dead father. So Rugby Chapel is a personal elegy and it is very, very famous poem of Matthew Arnold. It is a sad song because it is concerned with a sad event in the poet's own life. The death whom he is lamenting was the death of not an unknown person, not a strange person, but that death is, that death had been of his own father. So now you can understand very well that how much emotional this poem must be or would be, that when our son is reminding the sweet memories of his father, and now because his father is no more, so what he feels, what he thinks about his dead father, when he has arrived, he has come to visit the place where his father is buried. So Rugby Chapel is an elegy, a personal elegy, and it is written in the memory of the dead father, of the poet himself. Rugby Chapel is attached to Rugby School, and in this school, Dr. Thomas Arnold, the father of Matthew Arnold, had been a headmaster or a schoolmaster in this Rugby Chapel school, and the chapel or the church is also attached to this school. In the same school, Matthew Arnold, he himself had taken his early education, and in this school, his father was a master, maybe schoolmaster or maybe the headmaster. So Matthew Arnold is very sentimental here. He is very philosophical here, very sad here, because he is pondering over the memories of his dead father. So in brief, I'll try my best to summarize the whole elegy so that you may be aware of the concept of this elegy, Rugby Chapel. The poet, because 15 years have passed away since his father died. Now, after 15 years, Matthew Arnold comes or visits this place where his father is buried. He visits Rugby School some 15 years after his father's death, and it was the time of evening, an autumn evening. So the time of evening is also very peaceful, and there was a lot of darkness around. At once, suddenly the eyes of Matthew Arnold fall upon the chapel of the school, chapel that is the church of the Rugby School, and it reminds him that his father lies buried there. This turns towards his father, that his father is also lying there, and now he is no more. Arnold remembers very well that when his father was alive, what happened, and his father was very disciplined kind of person, very hard working. He used to be very, very happy when he was alive. And he, Matthew Arnold, and the other boys, they never felt sad, depressed, or gloomy in the presence of his father, because his father had always been very enthusiastic, very cheerful, and he had always been full of spirits. This was the character of Dr. Thomas Arnold, the father of Matthew Arnold. When we come to know that what kind of personality his father had at that time when he was in this world. So he is reminding all the qualities of his father, that how much happy, cheerful, full of enthusiasm he had been. His father had been just like a ray of light that filled the dark atmosphere. When his father arrived, that he was so full of cheerfulness, he was so full of light that there was no darkness around him. The person, whoever came in his company, he also used to get the same rays of light. And Matthew Arnold also feels that his father had been like a great big shady oak tree. Arnold compares his father with a tree, a great tree, a shady tree, under whose wide branches everyone had lived secure and protected. This was the protection of the father. When our father is with us, we always feel ourselves very protected, very secured, and there we feel no problem in our lives. The same happens with the poet, how much emotional he is getting here, reminding the sweet memories of his father, that when his father was alive, how much protected and secured they all, he and his family, they all felt. But during the last 15 years, because 15 years have passed away, during the last 15 years, everyone had been deprived of this shade, this security, this protection. And the difficulties are still, they are still, and they all had been facing the difficulties of life. But when his father was alive, they never felt those kind of difficulties. Difficulties were at that time also, but it was his father who suffered a lot. It was his father who never let them felt those difficulties, because he worked just like a big tree and protected all over them with his large branches. The security and the protection that was felt by the poet at that moment is very, very universal. This time they all are without their father's protection. And he's sure that God would not allow such a virtuous, such a great person. He had been a very great soul, and God would never admit the waste, all the talent of his father in idleness. His father must be carrying on his work in some other world, who knows? So maybe that he must be with his father, with his God. His father must be with his God, and he must still be doing God's will, because he had a very firm soul. He didn't have a lazy soul and a sluggish soul. But when he was alive, he had been very, very hardworking. So now Matthew Arnold is sure that wherever his father is, he is still working at the will of God, just as he had done in this world. So he must be working in another world also. And what he did, he must be encouraging, his father must be encouraging, helping the humble people, to be good, and he must be repressing the evil people from doing evil. His strong voice must be rousing those who do not see the difference between good and evil. So this is the duty of a person on this earth also. And the same was being done in another world by his father, that he was repressing, he was suppressing all the evilness of human beings. Such people have half closed eyes, so they cannot see clearly. And this is the duty of a person to show them the right path, to tell them what is right and what is wrong. His father wakes them up with his firm voice and makes them see the good. Arnold is very, very sure that his father is doing the same work in another world. When Arnold thinks about the life of his father, that how much purposeful, how much dutiful the life of his father had been in this world when he was alive, then he becomes very, very philosophical, and he starts to think about human life, about human life in general. And he says that in this world, most of the people, they move here and there, they wander, and they don't have any kind of purpose in their lives. They move here and there aimlessly, and they always spend their entire life, their entire time in doing nothing, simply in eating, drinking, chatting, or simply that loving, hating, then earn more and more money, than to either waste it or to spend it. They spend or they waste their entire life only in these activities, and they spend their lives, entire life, rising to high social positions and then falling from them. So they are leading purposeless life. They work hard in life, but they achieve nothing, and they think that this is the purpose of life. As soon as they are dead, everyone forgets about them. So here the poet becomes very philosophical, very serious, when he starts to think the purpose of man, of this life, and on this earth, that he comes here and he goes from here but achieving nothing. People who are inspired by a great thirst, the desire to do good, to help others, to serve suffering humanity, such people do not want to live like the common people in the crowd, wasting their life in futile, aimless activity. And they want to do something valuable for the humanity before they die. They do not want to live this life only to go to grave, only to die. And among such men is the poet. The poet Matthew Arnold wants to lead such life, the life of purposefulness. He doesn't want to waste his life doing nothing for others. Just like his father, he also wants to do something in favor of the humanity, suffering humanity. He wants to serve. He and others have chosen their way in life. They have a clear goal. But this way of life, the clear aim, that is the moral life, to serve the suffering humanity. But this way of life is a difficult journey that passes over high mountains. The person who make the purpose of their life, they start such a journey that is full of difficulties, full of snow fields, full of rivers. But after overcoming these difficulties, when they reach their goal, when they stand in front of death, then they feel that they have saved only themselves, and God is not happy, God is not satisfied with these kinds of people who only serve themselves, satisfy themselves, or who reach in the abode of God completely alone, not with other human beings. They have not been able to help and save others. Matthew Arnold thinks that his father was very, very different from others, and he was not like such men who saves or who saved only himself. But he did not wish to save only himself but also others. His father always helped the weak, helpless, poor, disabled, downtrodden people, and he wanted them to reach heaven with him. His father didn't like to go alone to the heaven, but he wanted to have the company of others also, who was wandering here and there and who didn't have a difference between evil and good. He never lost his cheerfulness, firm determination, even when he faced the greatest difficulties in his life when he was alive. Only such a man like him, like his father, could save others. And such men are God's sons, for they carry out God's will with a willing heart and deep devotion. Arnold says that the larger part of humanity is struggling in life. Most people have become hopeless, weak, disheartened, depressed because of these difficulties. They find it difficult to lead a moral, virtuous life and thus achieve heaven. Men like his father are needed to guide them, to show them the way, to help the weak. And his father did very well this duty, this work in his life. Only then men can get the grace to complete their journey in life and reach the city of God.